Hello everybody, my name is Joseph. I'm a grad student from NC State here in the Forest Biomaterial Department. And today we are going to show you how to do the deinking process of recycling paper. The idea here is to show you in a lab experiment how this is done and why this is important for the industry. But first, let me put my PPE protective equipment, like my glasses, my glove, my lab coat, and of course my face mask, before jumping into the lab. Today we are in the chemistry lab of the Forest Biomaterials Department, and we are going to perform our deinking process experiment right here. In order to do this experiment, we are going to need this equipment that we are showing here. Of course, we need the printed paper right there in the desk. We are going to need a blender to mix the paper with the water, some blotter paper. That black box is the handsheet maker. We will need that. And also a big tray to keep the water on it. The chemicals we are using is a foaming agent. Also, we need an air pump to remove the ink in the process, and some trays to not make a mess in this process. We will show you step by step how to use it. The first step is to put a printed sheet of paper, 4.5 grams of it, in the cup. It doesn't really matter the size of it, as long as you can put everything on the cup. Next step is to collect 1 liter of warm water. For that, we will use this cylinder here. And then we can pour that water into the blender. Now we need to put our tear paper into the warm water. Make sure that you remove your fingers first, and then you can cover the blender and you will stir the paper with the water for 45 seconds. Once again, we are blending the recycled paper with the water for 45 seconds. Once our paper is blended, we can use our foaming agent, 5 drops, and put it into the mixture. The foaming agent is used to separate the ink from the paper fibers and helping to generate some bubbles on the mixture. Use a stirrer to mix this mixture. Don't blend it again because it will generate a lot of foam, and we don't want that. Now we need to add cold tap water until the top of the blender. Make sure that the level reaches the top. The next step is to introduce our pump, air pump, into the bottom of the blender to start generating the deinking process. What is going to happen is that we are going to blow some air, and the bubbles will rise with the ink, and our job is just to remove that ink from the mixture. So we are keeping our ink with the foam, removing that foam, and keeping our fibers in the bottom of the blender. For that, we use a ruler to scrape the foam out of the blender. So this is our deinking process. We are bubbling air from the bottom to the top of the blender, generating our foam. This one is collecting the ink from the fibers of the paper, and our job is with the ruler scrub out that foam and removing the ink. So we have to do the inking process for 3 minutes. So keep scraping the foam out of the blender for 3 minutes. So you can see in the bottom of the blender that the ink turns the foam black. This is what we call the rejects. The fiber and water into the blender is what we call the accepts. We need to remember these terms for the calculations later. Now let's jump into the handsheet making process. For this, you will need the mold to do the handsheets and pour a lot of water on it, enough water to cover the screen in the mold with about 2 inches of water. now that we are sure that we have the correct level, we carefully pour our water with our fibers into the mold. Try to not spill the mixture outside of the mold. So you could re-rinse the blender and make sure that no fiber is left behind. Put everything in the mold. So go ahead and remove swiftly the mold of the handshakes out of the water. Remove the top of the mold and you will be able to see your handshake formed. Now, what we are doing here is to use some blotter paper to remove the excessive water out of the handshakes. Use two or three blotters to remove the excess water. The next thing that I will do is to flip the mold and try to carefully remove or separate the handshakes from the mold. As you can see, your handshake will be attached to the blotters. So keep continuing or keep going with the using the blotters to remove that excess of water from the handshakes. You can see your handshake paper underneath of the blotter paper. Now let's try our handshake paper. Make sure that it's in between two blotter papers and put it into the fast dryer for a few minutes. Now that our handshake is dry, it's time to weigh it. Make sure that you are recording this number for the calculations. Now let me explain you how to calculate percentage yield. Percentage yield will give us information about how much fiber we are recovering in our deinking process. So remember, the initial mass of the paper was the 4.5 grams of paper that we tear at the beginning. The final mass of the paper will be the weight of the handsheet that we prepare at the end of this experience. In this case, it was 2.5 grams. If you calculate this number, you will have roughly a 55% of recovering process. This means that we recover around 55% of the fiber that we had initially before the deinking process. It is important to understand the influence of the variables in this process. For instance, if we use recycled paper, we will have a bright handsheet like the one in the right. But if we use magazine paper that has more ink on it, we will have a darker handsheet. One way to determine how good is our process for ink removal is to use the contaminant removal efficiency. What we are comparing here is the amount of spots in a 1 centimeter square between the handshakes made with and without the ink removal process. The ink removal process will generate less spots, so we are comparing how much of that spots we are removing. That number will give us how good that process was.